Once upon a time, there was a man named Desi. He had a lot of cows, but there was only one problem. He didn't know how to count them. So when one day a thief stole some of his cows, Desi got really confused about how many cows the thief stole or how many cows he did still have. Desi was a clever man, so he found a very easy way for counting. Desi's way was, use your fingers for counting. Simply, each of the fingers will represent each of the cows. So Desi started counting. For the first cow, he raised his first finger and said 1. For the second cow, he raised his second finger and said 2. For the third cow, third finger, said 3, 4, 5. He kept counting 6, 7, 8, 9, and wait. There is the one last finger left. So after counting 9, if he said, this is kind, like we say 6, 7, 8, after counting 9, if he said, this is going to be pine, kind, and next one going to be kind, and the next one going to be time, there would be a great problem. For every different number, there would be a different name, and you just can't remember so many different names. So Desi didn't do that. What he did an amazing thing. After counting 9, he called the last finger 10, where 10 means I have counted all my fingers once. Now, once I know I have counted all my fingers once, I can again start counting from using these fingers. So, after counting 10, he said, for the next cow, 10 and 1, 10 and 2, 10 and 3, 10 and 4. And this way, he kept counting. This system worked really nice for him. And everyone wanted to know about this system. They asked Desi, teach us about your system. We want to count our cows like you. So Desi said, I invented this system, and this is going to be called decimal system. And in this system, you start counting from 1, count all the way to the last finger, and then call the last finger 10, right? 10 means you have counted all your fingers once. And once you know you have counted all your fingers once, so you can again use them. You can again use them for counting. It's so simple. So people also start using this method, and they also successfully counted their cows. This system worked for everyone except a person. His name was Octave, and he had only 8 fingers on his hands. So when Octo applied this rule, something different happened. Octo started counting using Desi's rule. So for the first cow, he raised his first finger and said 1. For the second cow, he raised his second finger and said 2. And this way, he kept counting all the way to 7. And then he realized, Octo said, hold the last finger 10. And he had only 1 finger left, so he called it 10. After counting 7, Octo called 10, and then again start using from the beginning, 10 and 1, 10 and 2, 10 and 3, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and then 20. This looks weird, but it also worked, and people called it octal system. So what's the difference between decimal system and octal system? Well, in decimal system, you have 10 fingers on your hands. In octal system, you have 8 fingers on your hands. So, 2 fingers less. That's why Octo avoided 8 and 9. And there is no 8 and 9 in octal system. In octal system, 8 and 9 are replaced by the other numbers. For example, what is 7 in decimal system is also 7 in octal system. But what is 8 in decimal system is actually 10 in octal system. What is 9 in decimal system is actually 11 in octal system. Octal system works that way. You're probably wondering, what if someone has less finger? What if someone has less than 5, 4, 3, or what if someone has only 2 fingers on their hands? How this person, or maybe an alien, how this thing will count? Well, it's all easy, it's all same to the Desi's rule. Start counting from 1, call the last finger 10, and then again start using from the first fingers. Think me as an alien. I have only 2 fingers on my hands, and I'm going to count. For the first finger, I say 1, and this is the last finger, so I must have to say it 10. So 1, then 10, and then start using your fingers again. 1, 10, and then 10 and 1, 11, and then 100. I know it's look more weird and more different, but trust me, this system also works, and this is called the binary system.
So what's the difference between the decimal system and the binary system?
Well, it's just like the before. In decimal system, you have 10 fingers on your hands, and in binary system, you have only 2 fingers on your hands. So you first say 1, and then you say 10. You just avoid 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, all these numbers. And in binary system, there is no 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 numbers. They are replaced by the other numbers. For example, in decimal system, what is 1 is also 1 in binary system. But in decimal system, what is 2 is actually 10 in binary system. In decimal system, what is 3 is actually 11 in binary system, and binary system works this way.
You may thinking, who has 2 fingers on their hands, and who the heck is going to count using these 2 fingers?
Well, surprise, there lives among us. It's the computer. Computers have 2 fingers on their hands, and they do all the stuff, all the calculation, all the processing using these 2 fingers, and they do count in this binary system. And you here watching also know how the computers count. Isn't it amazing?
If you think it's really interesting, then I will leave you with one last question.
The question is, what if someone has more fingers, more than 10 fingers? What if someone has 14, 15, or what if someone has 16 fingers on their hands? How this person will count? I think you already know how to find it, right? It's all Dessie's rule again. Start counting from 1, count all the way to the last finger, call the last finger 10, and then again start using your fingers from the beginning. I know you can find it, but I can just give you a hint. The hint is, after counting 9, when there are still so many fingers left, you may name them ABC and keep counting them, calling ABC. Count them all the way to the last finger, and then again call the last finger 10, just like the before. I know you can easily do it. So pause the video and try to count, pretending you have 16 fingers on your hand. If you are done with counting like 16 fingers on your hand, congratulations! You have successfully learned hexadecimal system. And from the beginning, you have learned decimal system, octal system, binary system, and now hexadecimal system. Congratulations, you genius!
If you really like the story and don't want to miss the next story, then hit the subscribe button.
And if you have to ask any question related to the topic, off topic or off topic, then don't worry, comment below. I will try to answer you on the next video. Until then, happy storytelling.